boy. It's Sideways JB. All right, so we making us a chili, a homemade chili. And the wife trying to coax the big lab that snuck in the dope out the house. Yeah, she done it. Get out of here, stupid. Anyway, so I'm using a Rick Fowler's all-natural two-alarm chili kit. The only reason I'm using that is because they got the seasonings right for the chili, the oregano, cumin, sawdust in a bag, which is freeze-dried onions and garlic. We ain't using that. They got the paprika measured out, the salt measured out, the red pepper measured out, and the masa flour, masa, and that thickens it up in the end. So what I did already was cut up an onion and cut up a bell pepper, and I got some ground meat. I think it's ground round because it was on sale. 85, 15, whatever.
Now take a picture of this and how much is gone that Christy made.
My daughter made that the other day. It's a rainbow cake. Yum. We ate that too. Anyway, so the only reason this is cheap. Rick Fowler was an award-winning chef at a chili cook-off at the International Chili Society. So anyway, instead of using the sawdust package here, we're going to go ahead and use some real onions like I already did, and I'm going to chop up some garlic and put in there too. All right? So the ground meat sauteing down, we got to drain it, and then we're going to proceed with the other dry ingredients here. The garlic can't go in until I add the recommended amount of tomato sauce and diced tomatoes. Are you in my way, boy? Anyway, that was Mrs. JB. Always in the way. Garlic, meat hammer. Now, it's all ready to go put in the chili. All right, garlic going in there. Come on. Tomato sauce. Oh, you gotta open the can, idiot. All right. I got some diced tomatoes going in with the juice. Good. The salt package going in. The chili powder going in. And this is why I bought this little package, because all these ingredients are already measured out for this amount of ground meat. And the mix is cheap. Cheap, 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 cheap. Paprika package going in. Come out of there, boy. No, throw the whole damn package in. Okay. Eat that too. The cumin and oregano going in. And I'm thinking it may need a little bit more of that. Because that's good stuff right there. Mix it all about. Some tomato sauce, one can. Gotta add some water to that too to rinse that. Wine, wine, wine. Now the recipe called for one can of tomato sauce and two cans of water. We added one can of tomato sauce, one can of diced tomatoes. Guess what? I ain't gonna go with all that much wine. So it would be a half a can of wine, half a can of water. Fitting to lose the battery, but dad go. Now this got to cook down for a little while. But I'm going to check it for seasoning. Oh, we got to put the red peppers in there. If you like it hot, it says use the whole bag. If you want it mild, don't use the bag. I'm going to use half the bag. Or at least some of it. Because this is good for the next day. What do you think I meant by that? Alright, so to recap, why did I buy this? Because everything is pre-measured in here for the grind meat. But look, down here on the bottom it says, make it your way by adding one or more of the following. Beans, if you want them. Can of diced tomatoes, which I did. Chopped green and green peppers and onion. And garlic, I ain't say that, but I did. And wine. So, it's pre-measured for the amount of grind meat that's in here. That's why I use that mix for the jambalaya. All it is rice with the right amount of salt and seasoning, but I always add Trinity and other stuff to it. Boy, girl, and dog. I would omit this package of sawdust. You can... Oh, look, it landed way up on top of the cabinet. That's good. It can stay up. See, Cajuns is bad about not measuring shit. I know y'all seen my videos where I measure a little bit of this, some of that, some of that. But the only thing that's really pre-measured is a can of this or a can of that. And put it in there. But nothing else is really measured other than we're going to chop up an onion. What size onion? Is it a big onion or a small onion? Or a medium onion? Same way with bell pepper, same way with garlic. Put as much as you like. Boy. So what I did was put a little bit of butter on this hot dog bun and griddled it. Now we're going to take one of these beef brats and go griddle it too. And that's for the chili with the hot dogs. Non-union package. Yeah, I knew you from Yankee Land. Alright, so we're going to go griddle this. Look over here, boy. Alright, JB made a little ripper in this little skillet. And we're going to drain that. That looks good to me. I also got a little salad right here. Over here, boy. And I made some wine vinegar, EVOO, and garlic salad dressing. It's going right on top of that. Yum. Lick the stuff out. That a ripper. See why you call it a ripper? Look, skinned and ripped. Put you some mustard on there. And anything else you want. I'm going to get some chili and pile it on. And then put some onions on top. With some cheese, chili, a little more chili.
Why is this so dark red?
More chili.